your back, and it didn't look like you were too worried that when you were out there right before the win, when you got back up.
No, sir. I've trained with some of the Gracie Jiu-Jitsu guys out in Philly. Lots of them, some years ago. Zach Boucher, one of my jiu-jitsu coaches, put me in that position all the time, and I'm comfortable. Even though he's only 200 pounds, he makes it seem like he's 250, and I knew exactly what to do. I was comfortable. I've been punched before. I've been doing this for a long time before I started fighting, so this is just a walk in the park to me.
I saw you applied the lockdown, too, keeping him in your guard. It made it hard for him to pass before you stood up. Was that something that you were working to hope to get back to your feet for that KO?
That's how I got to stop my guy, Zach. He goes, yes, it is. And the pressure on the hips, so he don't get a good base. Like I say, this is we work these things. Even though it was a last-minute replacement, I perfect everything. Everything. I don't let nothing go. I have to learn it all. So, not opponent change, 2 month camp, 2 weeks, I don't care. I do it.
Nice work. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Kelvin, obviously you're in the heavyweight division. There's some really serious hitters in this division. None bigger than you right now. You've landed an unbelievable shot. Do you believe this is a big statement to the rest of these guys?
Yes, sir. I do. And they all going to see me. And I'm going to kick all their butts. Every single one of them. Right, get them my way. I'm stopping them. I promise.
There's 12 guys. You're one of a dozen guys. Mm-hmm. Been a lot of shuffling. You're supposed to face a different opponent. Mm-hmm. Last minute change.
He got lucky.
Were you okay about that? Were you okay with the change, or were you upset?
No. I just wanted to get my check. Maybe that's all I wanted. As long as the check stay the same, I'm cool.
Who in this division are you looking at as your biggest threat right now?
Me. As long as I get up, work out, listen to my team, my guys, and I'll be okay. I don't worry about none of them. I don't worry about what they do. I don't worry about how good or what their records are, or they from Brazil or from Goku Land. I don't care. I do what I do. I listen to my guys, and you see what the outcome is.
Right, obviously, this is a big situation. You're at Madison Square Garden, yes. Obviously a very famous arena, yes. Most famous city in the world.
My coach always wanted to come here. I finally got him here.
You know, you're a young fighter. Mm-hmm. You know, kind of an unknown, mm-hmm, up until this point.
Yes.
You got a chance to win $1 million. Mm-hmm. And you think you got enough experience and you'll be able to handle that kind of pressure?
More than enough. I've been waiting for this opportunity for a long, long time. Injuries just kicked me out. Yeah, see, I'm healthy. My strength and conditioning coach right here, Marquis Caesar, my nutritionist, they're going to keep me going. They're going to have me about 250 next time, so some abs, and we're just going to keep knocking them out. I'm ready. I got all the experience in the world. Like I say, I'm my biggest threat.
Any chance? I know, obviously, you sounded like you really wanted a piece of Nicholson. Any chance you'd ask for him in the next matchup?
I don't have no preference of nobody. I'm going to beat them all, whoever get in front of me. Whoever come. I don't dislike the guy. He just dodged the bullet. That's all I'm saying. He's a good guy. I talk to him. But this is my job. I work for PFL now. And this is all that I want to do. I don't want to go back and cut grass. I want to kick some butt. I want to work out. I want to eat some chicken. Not really no chicken. But I want to do my thing. This is my home right now. I'm going to stay here.
Last question. I know, obviously, you got a lot of drilling going through.
Yes, sir.
Do you feel any injuries right now? Any hand or anything?
My shin hurt, but it ain't no... I don't know if you guys see... I just now seeing that. But no, I'm good. I can walk. I can talk. Like I say, these guys, they prepare me for battle. And then my kids always beat me up. So we all good, man. I'm good.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Two quick ones here.
Yes, sir.
What does it mean to you be on the first ever PFL event?
Oh, man, it means a lot to me. Like I said, just a month ago, I was trying to figure out how to start my own business and cutting grass. You know, I was scraping the money to get a lawnmower, a truck, just to go. So, and then I get the call, and then it's just Madison Square Garden. I'm fighting for $1 million. Like, I literally cried, man, when I signed my contract. So it means a lot to me. I don't want this to leave. I want this to stay. I want to win it. I want to win it again and again and again. And so it just means so much to me. I can take care of my family, my kids, and I can take care of my team that's been putting so much time in. These guys don't charge me nothing. You know, I know this is off the question, but they got businesses to run. You know, for years they have never charged me a dollar, a penny. They just say, get your butt to practice. So that means so much to me. I love these guys, and I love PFL for giving me this opportunity, and I'm gonna keep it going.
It's obviously a season format, which is different from anything else anyone's ever done. Are you training differently? How hard is it for you not to throw an elbow in there right now?
I don't throw elbows much. It was never. It wasn't a big change for me. Mm-hmm. It like I say, it all comes natural. They say don't knee, I won't knee. I've trained with boxers, I've trained with kickboxers, I've trained with jiu-jitsu guys, and I've been mentally preparing myself for all of these things for the last 10 years. So if y'all said no kicks, I would be perfectly fine, I promise.
What's your message to the rest of the rest of the division? And what's going from not having a spot like a month ago or so ago to if you win it, what will that react? Do you have a picture in your mind of what that reaction will be?
I'm sorry, I don't get that question. It was like,
if going from not having the spot in the PFL initially, and then if you go on to win it like you say you're going to do, do you know what that feeling is going to be like?
I don't, because I never had $1 million before. When I get it, I'm going to call you personally. What's your name?
Doug.
Doug? Yep. Doug, what up, bro? I'm rich. Thank you.